I didn't get very far here. And as you might be able to tell, I got up to a spawn point, drove my vehicle, and they've spawned me into a car. Hello, absolutely nobody. It's Fat Wap here. Welcome back. Day 16, 7 days to die on the PlayStation 4. You've just caught me watching a beautiful sunrise over this massive lake. You sneaky little man. You're getting it. There you go. You have no head. You can't watch the sunrise with me. Anyway. So, I'm just going to move my mic around because I think it's too close to my mouth again. In the last episode, you saw me do an epic road trip where I pretty much edged the map along the kind of derelict zone on the edge from way down here. So in the last episode, you were bored and you watched me come from down from here all the way down and around. I'm not going to go over it again because it was boring. We had a couple of good fights on the way though. And when you left me, I was just coming in to the start of this this town here. So during the night, you know, I logged off because I was pretty bored of the game at the bad time after doing an hour worth of riding. I thought I could hear a zombie. So I just logged back in and I decided I'd spend the rest of the night just driving up and down these streets. So I've pretty much unlocked all of this city we found here. Now there's a couple of good shops. There's I think there's one of everything. There's a Shamui Foods, Cracker Brick, blah 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 blah. So they're all in this city here. But again, this is another city which is surrounded by, as you can see, surrounded by lake with one road in, I suppose two roads in and two roads out, depending on how you want to put it. So you can see this is the road that we came in and there's only one road out that goes up this way. So that's where we're going today. But for the start, what I'm going to do is I'm going to raid the shops up here. Do something a little bit different. But what I'll do before I get into the town, I'll have a quick look at my mini bike. Come on, let me in. Because what we want to be doing is we want to be putting stuff away so we've got space for what we're going to raid here. So I'll drop all this because they're just things that I made to use them up to up our skill. I'll put that away. I don't want fibers. All this stuff's okay. Paper. Oh, hello. Can I get two headshots in a row? And she's dead. Oh, look at how much food she's got. Ridiculous. That's going to keep me going for a long time. Right, anyway, sorry. So, what we're doing. I am just going to dump everything in the mini bike for the time being. We'll do inventory management later. I don't necessarily need any of this stuff. I don't have a gun to use. Okay, and we'll keep the scrap and we'll keep the wood. I mean, realistically, do we need 12 wood frames? Do we need some sand? Do we need some stone? I'll keep the feathers. We certainly don't need a skull cap. The nails can go as well. And I will stick the rest of these tools away in my backpack for the time being. And it looks like we can combine these two piles of bolts almost, and the wood can go up in the top corner. So, as you can see, we've got a good amount of stuff. I mean, that's about to die anyway, so we'll have another space when that does. So, what we're going to do, get on my bike, and we're going to head across to the first shop. Now, I'm going to obviously skip Shamui Foods, because that is next to useless. Which is the first shop we've come across. Now, all the shops, strangely, were on the first road we came down. So we're just going to head that way now. Hello, zombie. Oh, sorry, zombie. You should be careful crossing the road. No jaywalking, as it is in America. Right, so we're going to go around here, because this is where all the shops are going to spawn in. I've got no specific order in which we want to go with them in, so we'll just first come, first serve. In fact, what I'll do first though is I'll switch my light off so I don't waste any more battery. You can see everything spawning in. Oh, it's been a bit weird. Before, when I was driving around, I was trapped spawning in, as you know how it does. And a zombie from the spawned in area came running up to me and started hitting me. You can imagine I wasn't best pleased. I'll take all that. Nothing I could do because I couldn't move, because I was busy spawning in. You know. Oh, this is why. Oh no, this is why the sledgehammer is so good. But this is why the sledgehammer is also so very bad. Just decreased in my health as well. You can go down. And she's already dead. Right, let's have a quick search of these. I'll take the water because I'm on a road trip and fresh water is always handy on a road trip. I can see another one coming up to me. I'll take all that. He's a big guy. He's not big enough to take down my sledgehammer. And we'll get the nurse. So a quick search of these guys, because... Oh, I mean, five duct tape is a good haul. Haha! Not quick enough, zombie. Take a shorter swing next time. Alright, so let's get my axe. We'll go in the window, as we always do. Saves breaking down the door. We're overheating, which is fantastic news. What do I actually have on? I bet you I'm naked. Overheating with absolutely no clothes on. So I could probably take my trousers off. Oh, why does it do that? I'll take my trousers off for the time being and we'll start reading this. Is it working stiff tools I came in? Start reading this working stiff tools. We'll just collect everything for the time being, then we'll be ruthless and scrap everything down afterwards. As we always do. I were not really after anything specific in this shop, because we've got pretty much everything we want. I don't know if we've got calipers at home. Are they called calipers? I think they are. The little tool for your forge. So we're looking for them, I think. I can't actually remember, I'm honest, because it's been a while since we've been home. But everything else we'll just collect quickly. We'll ditch what we don't want at some point. Because as you can see, you know, you come into a working stiff tools, and after four boxes and a couple of the bins and the cupboards, you're pretty much your inventory is pretty full. So it's not going to take as long to fill up our inventory in this area. Then we've got a cracker book next to us, and we definitely need to go into the Shotgun Messiah, because we really want to be starting making some decent weapons now. We're at that stage in our game where we can start unlocking the good perks and getting the good weapon parts, because as you can see from reading these boxes, I'm getting pretty high level blue stuff. I mean, what did I pick up there? Blue wrench, some greens and oranges. So, you know, we're doing okay for the level of stuff we're picking up. You know, at the start, is it really worth picking up a brown pistol barrel? Not really. Because by the time you start picking that stuff up, you've already got a better bow. So I suppose, yeah, we're in that point in our game where we really want to start thinking about weapons. So I'll just take down this safe. It shouldn't take too long with this big pick. And we've got the chance as well that it might take the pick out completely. And then we can just scrap it down. Freeze up an inventory spot. While I'm doing that, I'm going to take a drink. Sorry for smacking the mic with my glass there. A couple more hits. And we're in the safe. Let's have a look. Some gun parts. So that's okay. We'll take the hunting rifle parts. It's always good. They're not the best hunting rifle parts, but, you know. If we find the three other hunting rifle parts, we'll have a full hunting rifle. Which is something we don't have at the moment. Right, so. We've pretty much raided everything now. So, if we look at it logically, we don't want a can. We can keep that lady killer challenge. In fact, we might as well read it as well. Because it's just telling us to kill some female zombies, and it'll give us a list of the zombies we want to kill. It'll more likely give us a time limit as well. but we're not going to worry about that right now. Some antibiotics. Scrap down that. Scrap down that. Scrap down that. Can we scrap them? Just drop that. We'll scrap the doors. Scrap the anvil. These are our tool sets where we want to keep these. Don't care about the rebar frames. And we'll scrap down that wrench, that axe, and we've got a queue. That wrench. And this is going to take 60 seconds, so we can actually start. We can go back on our way now, rather than just standing for a minute. So out we go, into the net. So let's see what's in this basket. I've not really searched that yet. And we'll take all that. Okay. So what we've got to bear in mind as well is that we're going to be pretty. Our inventory is going to be pretty full after this little raid of all these shops, because we've got this one here, and there is a shotgun messiah. I drove past it, I can't remember where it is, but it'll be highlighted on the map anyway. Oh, is he swinging for me? Oh, there you go. The crawlers are really... I find the crawlers really difficult to hit. Alright. There's a jumping lady. I'll go on the other side just to make it a little bit easier on myself. In fact, I like going in here. There we go. See if I can get this girl on a headshot. Oh, she should add. Oh dear, I'll just sledgehammer her. She should I was going to say she should count towards our task at the top right hand corner, which is she was a decayed mother. I'll take the water. Oh, hello. This lady should count as well. I don't know what she is yet. Putrid girl, is she? There you go, putrid girl, or departed woman, whatever she was. So we've got a putrid girl and a nurse. So, you know, already we're doing quite well. So what I'll do is I'll whiz through this. I won't take too much time reading them. I'll just stash the books for the time being. And in fact, while we're here, I'll start just scrapping all the stuff down as well, because we don't want any of this in our inventory, really. We've got loads of water now as well, which is fantastic, so I can actually scrap that and scrap that as well. No, I can't, because there's a cube. So again, we'll just absolutely whiz around. I'm not going to bother reading them just at the moment, because I suppose the idea of this episode is just to raid the town as quickly as possible and get out. So we can do that relatively easily. I mean, I think looking at the books we're picking up, we've already got most of them. Now if I find, you know, if I do find a gun book, I know we've got the Enforcer book there, but if I do find like a hunting rifle book or a shotgun book, I'm going to read it, because I'm not sure what books we actually have. And there's a rocket launcher book I'm not interested in. Sniper rifle book, let's have a read. Read that. Okay, so we didn't actually have the sniper rifle book. That was a good thing. We'll see if we've got there. We'll read the Enforcer book while we're here. Well, I was just taking a drink. We already had... Oh no, we didn't have the Enforcer book. So this is perfect. So we've already picked up the sniper rifle book and the Magnum book. We do have the pistol book already. And I'm pretty sure we've got the shotgun and the hunting rifle. So that should be us fully set. But I don't want to count my chickens, as they say. So any books we do find, we'll keep and read. What's this one? We've already got the hunting knife book. I know that for certain. We found two of them in that little weird house shop in the last episode. I think that was an AK book actually. So I'm gonna quickly read that AK book to see if we had that. Read that. We didn't have the AK book either. So this gun store, this bookstore here, has given us a fantastic amount of experience and books. There's a chainsaw. Did we have that? Yeah, we didn't even have the chainsaw book. And here's another six. We've got... I don't think I took that last book, did I? There you go. Right. I'm not going to bother with the back of the shop. So we're just going to, as I say, as quickly as possible, come in and out of these shops. There's a bunch of crawlers as well, so we'll take these guys out. Oh, I am 100% sure he was dead. Oh well. frustrating. I'll take that task, and we're off. Right, where's my bike? Right, we're going to have a quick look at the map, because I can't actually remember where the Shotgun Messiah was. I think it's that one there. So we'll go straight up a street, we should see it. For the Shotgun Messiah, I am going to have to spend a little bit of time reading those books. As I take another drink, I'm also popping pills. Damn you, I don't really care about popping pills, to be honest. Alright, let's stop outside here. Six books. we picked up a lot of books, but at least this will give us some nice XP. Now we've got 7 minutes and 37 seconds to find a putrid girl and a nurse. And then that way we'll get extra XP, so it might actually be worthwhile doing that. I'll scrap all this stuff while we're reading the books as well. I just wish there was a quicker way to do this, because this is, can be, I mean, how many books? I've got 12 books left to read or something like that. I'll read the rocket launcher book. I think we've probably already got that anyway. Not that does anyone else just ignore the rocket launcher, or do you guys use a rocket launcher? Do you find it useful? Do let me know in the comments, because if there's something worthwhile doing the rocket launcher. Oh shoot! I just scrapped that by accident. Lucky I was quick enough to do that. And we'll just keep going. Couple more reads. 4 more reads. Then we'll have to go quickly into the map again. In fact, I'll drink some water while I'm doing this, because I'm thirsty apparently. I'm busy, am I? I can't drink and read at the same time. My character's a woman. She can multitask. And one more drink of water. Right, okay. So into the map. Into the map, into the map. Now, I definitely saw Shotgun Messiah when I was driving around. So it might be... I don't think it is that one. But it might be this one. Down here. Unless I'm thinking about the bank. Right, so... Anyway, it's pretty much empty anyway. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back down the street, round the corner, see what that is, and then go straight back up here and out the top of the town. But I can hear someone smashing something up, and we are looking for, please do shout out, I know I won't hear you, please do shout out if you see a putrid girl or a nurse. There's the airdrop as well. Where did that drop? There. I'm not going all the way back there for an airdrop. There's not going to be anything useful in there anyway. I don't need any more beakers. Anyway, earlier on today, I was watching someone who comments on my videos quite a lot, Zachariah Flaves. And I noticed he had patched his system up to 1.10. He plays on the PlayStation 4 as well. If you haven't checked out his channel, please do. It's very good. He does live streaming. He seems like he's on all the time, really. So, good channel to check out. Did I just drive past where I was going to? Yeah, so it wasn't a... Maybe I didn't see a Shotgun Messiah. Maybe I was just making that up in my head. Anyway, yeah, so... So do check out his channel. But I noticed he patched himself up to 1.10. So that's exactly what I have just done. I got home from work and switched my computer on and saw there was a patch available to install. I'd already downloaded it, so I am now on patch 1.10. Sorry, just taking a drink there. In fact, while I'm telling you about patch 1.10, I might have a go. I'm sure that was full. Has some items disappeared from in here? Or did I just drop them? Anyway, the reason I was stopping is because I need to raid some cars for some fuel. So I am now on patch 1.10 as well. I haven't actually had the chance to read the patch notes yet. But I'm hoping what they've done is they've changed the spawn rate on the Horde Knights back to how it used to be, because You know, even though I started again and we did get a half decent spawn or horde night the other night, I don't feel it was I don't feel it was as strong as they used to be. So they might have fixed that. And I'm quite eager to see if they've added any kind of functionality from Alpha 15 from the from the PC version. So, you know, whether they've added any more. Let's just see how much fuel I've got now. Let's gas up. I'm going to be on the road anyway, so I'm half full, which is good. I'll keep going. I'm quite keen to see if they've added any functionality or items from Alpha 15. You know, the thing that I'm really, really keen on them adding into the console version is the updated workbench, because that honestly is priceless on the PC version, where you can take two items that are the same make and use them to repair each other or upgrade each other. That would be perfect. But we shall see. I won't do it while you guys are online. I'll spend a bit of time tonight looking through the menus to see if they've introduced anything new and beautiful, and if they have, I will show you tomorrow. I'll get this last car before we leave the town. Is that a duffel bag as well? I'll check the sports bag. Ooh! Hunting rifle parts. Tasty. I'll keep them because they're blue as well. And what we'll do is we'll just raid this car for the last bit of kind of fuel and scrap and such. Just make sure I'm not dropping anything, because I think my inventory is full now. Before I get back on the car, what I'll do, before I get back on my bike, sorry, I'll fill up. I will drop the oil because it's got no use to me. Scrap that. Scrap that. Scrap that. Scrap that. Headlights will stack. I don't really need cloth in that, but that can go in there. Is that engine better? That engine is better. So I'll swap the engines over, which means I will have to refuel, but that's not a problem. Refuel. I'll stick one of the waters in here. In fact, I'll take them as well and just scrap them, because we don't really care about this kind of stuff right now. Ditch that in there. Don't really want that. Okay, so we're kind of back to a decent enough inventory. I'll scrap that and I'll just drop that. So I'll keep these hunting rifle parts because they're 480, which is good. And we've also got some hunting rifle bullets here, so if we do find anything else we can make a hunting rifle with, that'd be perfect. So I suppose the idea now is we're going to go back on a road trip. So I'm not sure how far I'm going to bring you guys with me on this, whether or not I quit straight away. But you know, as you can see, this is another city that's surrounded by water almost, and we've just come from that way down here. So the idea is we'll finish this road to completion. So you know, it's more than likely going to come up here like this and hook onto this road. And if it does, I mean, that's not so much of a bad thing. I know I'm complaining about the map quite a lot at the moment, but the bottom half, this kind of section here, is a bit of a pain, and so is the water section here, because all of that's water. But if we find somewhere decent to stay here, then I don't think there's any water above here anyway, so it might be a good place to set up. But we'll see. So I'm hungry. I've got food on my bike, but we're only 25% hungry. I'll worry about that at a much later date, because we've got 14 fresh meat as well. So we could pretty much stop at some point and just cook that off, char it up and then eat it. That's going to give us 100% food, and we've got plenty of water to keep us hydrated. So we're in a good position right now. Oops. Sorry, zombie. So we'll just keep going and we'll see. I couldn't get out of the way, sorry zombie. So yeah, we're in a good position. We've got 60% fuel, which should get us a decent way around the map. There's some more bloody water here. We know about this lake anyway. So we'll keep on going. What I will do is I will go quiet now, and I will bring you back when I find something worth showing you guys. But you can kind of see where the road goes anyway. It's going up, round, over the left, over the hills over there, and probably along, you know, along this way. But I'll bring you back once I either get to the top of the hill and it's a dead end, or I'll find something interesting. And we also need to keep an eye out for zombies that we need to kill for women. In fact, is that one there? Do I need to kill her? Have I killed one of you already? Yes, I have. It's a putrid girl and nurse. Anyway, I'll bring you back soon. In fact, almost straight away. Is this a cave? Got to be careful. Looks like there's a cave here. So what I'll do is I will do what I always do. I'll mark this on the map as a cave, because these are always good for resources. So you can... I'll mark it with a cave item. You can see all the stalactites and stalagmites. They're all potassium nitrate, so they'll be perfect. Or you can... you fool. Anyway. So I'll keep going. Anyway, I'll go back quiet, and I'll cut you back in at a later date. I didn't get very far here. And as you might be able to tell, I got up to a spawn point, drove my vehicle, and they've spawned me into a car. I don't actually know what to do here. Oh, my bike is in a car. I'm gonna have to get this for a screenshot for my thumbnail. There you go. Oh dear. Let's see if I scrap the car. Hopefully if I my goodness. Every single time. I'm lucky I've got this wrench. So fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. Hey, I got my mini bike back. Anyway, I'll bring you guys back in a minute. Thank you. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. So it looks like I found another town by the looks of things. I haven't really come that far from when I showed you that stupid spawn. I think the stupid spawn was about here in the map somewhere. And we've come up and we found another city. So it looks like the top half of the map is the better place to stay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a quick lap of the city. I'll go back on, I'll cut you back in once I've done a quick lap of the city. And I will show you, unless this is one of the girls I need to kill. Is this one of the girls I need to kill for my my challenge? No, I've already got... Oh, no, maybe not. Yeah, so I'll get back on my bike, I'll do a quick lap of the city, and I'll bring you back, because it looks like we're going to stay here the night. It's getting late, so I'll do a quick lap, and I'll bring you back. Hey, everybody, that's me back. So I've done a quick lap of the city. It looks like a decent size. I still need to finish off this edge here to see if there's a road that goes off in this direction. I mean, we are literally right at the top of the map here. So I'm thinking the derelict area is going to be around about, the radiation area is going to be around about here. But we'll have a quick look anyway, because we are literally right at the top of the map. But that's not a bad thing, because we've got snow biomes around us all. If I can find the right city. So we have got snow biomes all the way down here. And as you can see, I am freezing, so I might actually... Have I got any more clothes? Where's my bike? I haven't got any more clothes. Got some cloth. Just make something cloth clothes quickly so I don't freeze to death. Cloth chest armor. That'll do for the time being. Cloth gloves. Hide poncho. So I'll put these on. This should stop our character from freezing to death, hopefully. Just for the time being, anyway. I could even make some fiber stuff if I'm really worried about my health. But I'm going back up in temperature now after I've put those clothes on. Anyway, I'm waffling. So the plan is, what I'm going to do is I'm going to head into this cracker book for the night. I'm going to head in there, spend the night in that cracker book, raiding the books. There's a Shamway Foods there. I don't really care about that. It looks like the police station's pretty done in. No, let's not go in the cracker book. Let's spend in the police station. And there's a working set of tools there, actually. So many good options. Just take him out. See, coming across. Yeah, so I think what I'll do, this is probably going to be a good place, I will grab my meat and a bit more. I don't really need that much food, do I? I'll do that. And then I will crack on the floor, make sure I get, unless there's a stone nearby, I need 8 bits of stone to make a campfire. And that's going to be enough. There you go, 13, that was in my actual inventory bar. Oh, I see how... One of the bad things about the sledgehammer is if you don't stun them, you're not going to be able to recover in time to hit them again. So anyway, so what I'll do is I'll head onto this building. I'll leave my mini bike there, it should be quite safe. And I will head back up. For those who don't know, this building's quite useful. It's a police station. Some dead bodies and whatnot in there, but if you head up the stairs, in this building, in this room here, you'll find a munitions box at the back. In this one here, there's sometimes a suitcase, sometimes there's something you'll get in. And in this room here, if I just open it up, there is a dead body and a gun safe. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to camp here for the night. I'm going to make a very quick campfire. You can hear, the zombies can hear me, but that's not really an issue right now. So what we can do is we can make a quick campfire. Sounds a bit closer than I thought. Stick in some fuel, and then char up all the meat, because we are hungry. So once that's meat all charred, I'll eat 100%, and I've got enough water to bring me back up to 100%. Just eat that quickly for the time being to get us some health before we go down. And then what I'll do is I'll spend a bit of time in this building tonight. I'll raid some stuff, I'll scrap some stuff, I'll do some inventory management. Blah blah blah. Yep, you know what I'm gonna do. And I'll bring you back in the morning. I'm still sensed. I'll bring you back in the morning, having raided that munitions box and that safe. And then what we'll do is we'll finish off the list of this town quickly. There was a shop over here as well. There's a couple of shops to raid. So tomorrow, in tomorrow's episode, we'll raid those shops and we'll finish our road trip. Because I'm fully expecting. I don't know where that road's going to go. One of these roads here has to hook up to here, and another road might come into the corner up here, and then I suppose that was our nice little trifecta of cities. Zero city here, a couple of cities up here. I can hear a zombie going mental. Where are they? They're going mental somewhere. Anyway, so I'm thinking, we've done the bottom half of the map. It's quite annoying. There's a nice little cave system here. I'm thinking I might start setting up a permanent base. Possibly around here somewhere. Snow biome close, maybe at this cross junction here. Because as you can see, at that cross junction, we can make it to that city quite easily. There might be a city or something up here. This city easily, which we haven't really even touched. And we've got the 00 city and these ones up here. So definitely the top half of the map is where we're going to be looking at setting up. And we don't even know what's over here, because there is a, as you can see, there is a road here that goes up. So it might be a case of we'll do a little bit more investigation, find out what's around right here, and maybe set up there. But we'll see. But that's going to be the next episode. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you haven't been too bored. It was a little bit more interesting than the last one. And while I eat my meat, I will call it a day and I will see you all tomorrow. So thank you. Take care. Bye now.